Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.2 Developer Beta 2. Now, if you're wondering where Public Beta 2 is, well, by the time you're watching this video, it could be out, and if it is, I'll let you know in the comments below, but sometimes it would be the next day, so we'll just have to wait and see, but hopefully it's out by the time you're watching this video. Now, this particular update came in at 1.14 gigabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and I saw it vary all the way up to 4 gigabytes depending on the device you're having. So it really depends on what device you have, but you could see it even smaller than this or even larger. Now, along with iOS 14.2 Developer Beta 2, Apple also released iPadOS 14.2 Beta 2, WatchOS 7.1 Beta 2, which fixes that blood oximetry issue if you were on the betas, and then also tvOS 14.2 Beta 2, as well as macOS Big Sur Beta 9. Now, we're still waiting for macOS Big Sur to release to the public, so hopefully we'll see that in a couple weeks. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at what's new. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the build number. We'll go to Settings, General, then About, and you can see the build number is 18B5061E. And so we're a little ways off from the final version, of course, with the E being at the end. And also included in this specific update is support now for iPhone XR and iPhone 11. So if you weren't able to get it before, initially they released it, but then they pulled it from the iPhone 11 and XR due to problems, and now it's back. So you should be able to install it. Also, watch faces are back. If you're running watchOS 7 or the betas and you're having problems with watch faces, they're now back on 7.1 beta 2. Now, there's a modem update for this specific update, and that is for my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It may vary from device to device, but I do have a modem update, so if you were having connectivity issues, I really wasn't having any with Beta 1, but if you were having them, there is an update, so hopefully it improves it. This doesn't count for Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, where people were having issues before. Now, the first new thing has to do with emoji. Apple has finally updated iOS 14.2 with the expected Emoji 13 release, and so here are all of the different ones. So starting from at the top here, you've got a disguised face, pinched fingers, a ninja, an anatomical heart, and there's quite a few new ones, and there's different colors for each one of these as well. I just used the generic yellow ones, but as you can see, everything from elevator down to the bottom, you've got a bunch of different ones, a military hat, a sandal, a needle with thread, and on and on and on. So this is just to comply with version 13 of Emoji. So this goes across everything from iOS to Android to Windows. So as long as those manufacturers update it, it will work across those devices. Now, another thing they've changed again has to do within the control center where it says not playing. If we press and hold on this, it's a little bit different. Now, I'm seeing suggestions here. If I go on iOS 14.2 beta 1, press and hold, you'll see that it looks a little bit different on beta 1. On beta 2, it's actually filling in the music. Some people are seeing just this look. I'm seeing it update on my iPhone 11 Pro Max with this sort of update. So you'll see it could look a little bit different depending on which device you're using and also which version you're on. Now, other than that, when you go into health, there's a new splash screen. So let's go into health on the iPhone XR since I haven't opened it yet. See if we can find it here. Just look for health. We'll go into health and you'll see there's a new splash screen that says improve health and activity. So it says share my data with Apple, don't share my data, and it has examples of data and usage. So it's up to you whether or not you want to share this, but this is just something new as far as a splash screen that shows up in this beta. Now, if you don't want to share it, you're good to go. So nothing new there. Now, that's really it as far as anything that's specific new that you can see initially, but there are some new changes to the wording. Thanks to my friend Steve Mosier, who actually informed me of this. It's hard to find some of these. So let's go into the Watch app, and under the Watch app, under noise, some of the wording has changed, as well as under hand washing as well. So they've just updated some of the wording within hand washing, and it just lets you know as far as data collection, if you're using that with hand washing. So there's some updated wording there. And that's really it for this particular update. It's basically an emoji update, as well as a new splash screen, some small tweaks and changes right now, and there's no known issues listed in Apple's notes for this update. But the good thing is there's a bunch of bug fixes. In fact, they've fixed every bug they mentioned in the previous version. So if you're having issues in beta 1 with say AirPlay, it seems to be working. They didn't mention that specifically, but I noticed it was super fast in this update. Also, they've fixed Apple Cache Family. That's now working. And you can now use Siri to send audio messages. There's a couple developer fixes as well. So all of those things are fixed in this particular update. Now, as far as battery life in iOS 14.2 beta 2, well, it will take a few days to know, but I can share with you my battery life from the previous versions. So if I go to my battery health again is 95%. If you've been following along, that's after about a year, regularly charging it on a stand at night. 80% after 2 years is normal. So let's take a look at beta 2. So beta one was not so great. You'll see yesterday I had 3 hours and 4 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 33 minutes of screen off time with about 30% usage. That's not great battery life, but that does mean I'm getting about 9 hours of screen on time. With iOS 13.6, 13.7, I was getting 10 to 12 hours of screen on time. Now with beta 2 of 14.2, I may actually be able to hit that again. I think Apple will fix this problem that we've been having all along. So I think iOS 14 people that are not seeing phenomenal battery life, hopefully will get it with this beta. Now, overall performance, I played around with this a little bit on the iPhone 7 and it seems to be okay. While the device is hot from processing, the back of this is fairly warm and giving off a lot of heat. In general, it feels like it's pretty fast. So I'm not seeing too many issues here. It seems like it's working fine and shouldn't really give too many issues to most people. Also with iPadOS, I don't see a whole lot of changes. Basically the same thing that you have on iPhone, you get on iPad. So iPadOS 14.2 beta 2, I put it on the oldest iPad Air just to show performance as well. And you'll see if I open Minecraft, it should load pretty quickly. I haven't opened it in a long time, but let's see what we get here. Now, overall frame rates appear to be pretty good on Minecraft here. So that's usually what I'm looking for, any stuttering or anything like that. And this is the older iPad Air 2. So this is the oldest, one of the oldest supported devices. And the back is getting a little bit warm as I'm playing it, but performance seems to be pretty decent. In fact, benchmarks show that it seems to be pretty good overall. So for example, if I go into Geekbench 5 here that I have on my 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,338 for single core, 3,467 for multi-core. Now, the first time I ran this, I actually got pretty terrible scores and then they improved when I ran it again. So you can see here, I had pretty bad scores initially, but based on what we've had before with say beta 1, the score seems to be much higher as far as the multi-core and even single core is a little bit higher as well. So I would expect this one to perform pretty well, especially after you give it a day or so. It seems to be performing well, and it's not even warm on my 11 Pro Max. Now let's take a look at all of these devices. So here are all the devices laid out with Geekbench scores on them. So on the left, we have the iPad Air 2, then the iPhone 7, then the iPhone XR, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And I did run it twice on the 11 Pro Max to hopefully get a little bit better scores and after it was done processing in the background. So if these are very low for you, then try again, maybe in an hour or so and see if they improve, but this should give you a general idea of what to expect. So that's it for iOS 14.2 beta 2. Now, if you're wondering if you should update to this version and you're already on iOS 14.2 beta 1, then I would say absolutely. This should fix a bunch of issues. However, if you're already on iOS 14 or 14.0.1, I wouldn't update to this one since it's an early beta. Now, if you're having major issues, then maybe try it out, but I really would hold off until Apple releases more versions or they come out with iOS 14.1. Now, we haven't seen that version yet, which is kind of weird, but I think we're going to see it with the release of iPhone 12. And so I would expect invites for the iPhone 12 event to go out probably on the 6th of October, with the event being the following Tuesday, and then the pre-orders or the pre-sale of iPhone 12s going for sale on that following Friday. Then a final release of them on the Friday after that. So that's usually how Apple does it. So look for iPhone 12 with iOS 14.1, hopefully in a couple weeks. Of course, I'll keep you updated. As far as I know, I'll let you know as well. Now, if I find anything else in iOS 14.2 beta 2, I'll do a follow-up with more new features later this week. And then I'll do the normal follow-up with all of the battery information and more based off the YouTube community poll on Sunday, like I normally do. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.